Hi, I'm Roseanne Ritter, and today I want to show you a way to make beautiful custom quilt labels. For years, I have been writing my label with an ink point pen on a piece of muslin and then attaching it to my quilt. I don't have an embroidery machine, so I wasn't doing that. But for the last couple of years, I've been using this program called canva.com. And I thought, wouldn't that make a great way to make custom quilt labels? As you can see, my background, I used canva.com to create my background for Zoom. And it just makes it a fun way to make a label. Now, you don't have to be tech savvy. I'm not a tech savvy person, but my friend Carol Witt showed me how to use canva.com, and it has been the best way I've found using the computer to use a computer program to create labels and Facebook posts, but I just wanted you to see what I've done. If you're not tech savvy, just enjoy the video and learn something. If you want to share this video with someone that is tech savvy and they can help you, feel free to share it. So I'm going to show you how to get started creating beautiful custom quilt labels using canva.com. I'm going to share my screen. And there, okay, hold on just a second. Get this out of the way. Okay, I'm going to use, here we're in canva.com. Canva.com. It is free. They do have things that you can purchase in there, different pictures, fonts. But when you register for canva.com, there are a lot of things for free, and don't worry about paying anything. I'll show you that as I go through. I'm going to show you what's required. I've got a little presentation here. Okay, what you'll need, your computer or your laptop, subscribe to canva.com, and it's free. You're going to need a computer printer. And then you're going to need some craft photo paper to print your labels on. And this is what my package looked like at the time. And I think I got it at a quilt store, and it was like $12.99 for 5 sheets. If you look on Amazon, you could probably get it a little cheaper. The last batch I got the other day was like 30 sheets for like $22. From what I understand, you can make your own photo fabric paper, but I really haven't tried it. I just heard my friend use it, and she got it to print, but I don't really know how to do that, so I'm not going to go into that. Now, I want to show you a couple examples of what I've done using canva.com. I've made a quilt for a friend, and I actually said thank you. We actually bartered. I made her a quilt. She gave me a very nice sewing machine. She didn't have any use for it anymore. So I made her a label to go on her quilt, and I said thank you. I actually picked a picture from Canva. They have a excellent selection of free photos in their photos over here. And then the words I used, I hope you enjoy this quilt as much as I enjoyed making it for you. And then I put my date, my name, the date that I made it, and I put my website so that she could find me at a later date if she wanted to. Another label I made was for a lady that I had met during the pandemic. She wanted me to make a rag quilt for her. And it was really, really nice to get to know her. She was a traveling nurse. I had fun making it for her. So her label, I searched photos I might have even searched photos on Google too, but I found a picture of a nurse and you could see the outline of her nurse's cap. And it was kind of neat. The lines in here represent the United States, all the states separated. So I chose that as my background. I think I downloaded it to my computer and then brought it up into Canva. I wrote words that I felt were appropriate for the quilt. And I said, amid a crisis, it is heartening to find friendship and vision. May this quilt bring you warmth, comfort, and peace, made especially for you by, and then I put my website and the date. And then I made a quilt for my son and his bride. And I actually labeled it M&J. That's the way they labeled it on their invitations. So I put M&J, the date, and I said, made especially for you by Roseanne Ritter. Congratulations and best wishes for an extraordinary life together. You made me happy. And I think I found the picture on the photos in here in canva.com. But I wanted to go back to show you in the home all the things that Canva can do for you. When you've got the home, let's see, recommended for you. When I've got it in home, Canva lets you do all kinds of designs. There. You could do photos, icons, social media, websites. You can print products like business cards, postcards, flyers. You can, I actually used Canva for my Zoom. I was able to create Zoom, a background for my Zoom. Let's see, move my picture over and it says create as design. And actually I can, I think I put Zoom. And see Zoom virtual background, and I can create my own background in Zoom. So Canva has changed a lot, even in the last 18 months that I've been, 2 years that I've been working with it. But I just thought I'd show you that. But I wanted to show you that. I want to show you a small example of how this works. And I made a label. I'm going to make a memory quilt for my father-in-law passed away. His name is Frank. So I'm going to make a few memory quilts for the relatives. And I want to show you how I made this label for him. I'm going to recreate it. Right here, I'm going to add a page. And so I think I chose like a postcard outline for this, and Canva calculates it all. So we're going to pick a background. And I think, let me go back. I picked a woodsy background. Frank was a very woodsy guy. He liked to create a lot of carpentry projects. And see how it says free. Canva has free backgrounds. So I picked a woodsy one because Frank did a lot of wood. Okay, and I'm going to choose text. And I'm going to select add a heading. And I'm going to move the heading, put it right there on that little directional. And I'm going to move it up. And here it shows me the kind of printing that it is. Canva gives you so many print options. Just, they're wonderful. And if it has a crown, it means it costs something. Other than that, it's they're all free. So I'm going to choose stick with what's there. I'm going to create another heading. I've got several lines. I'm just going to create, put them in there. So all I got to really do is fill it out. I've got about five lines, and this kind of, this background almost has built-in lines with it. So it makes it very simple. I'll just put there. I can readjust these too as I start typing. And then I'll see how this looks. So let me go back to the first line. And my first line is gonna say, all caps, and I want to highlight this so that it'll take away that add a heading. And I'm going to put remembering Frank, F-R-A-N-K. Okay, go to my second line, and I'm going to highlight it. I clicked on it. I have a MacBook Pro. If anybody's curious about what I've got, I'm going to put dad. He was a grandfather. F-A-T-A-D-R. And put that. I'm going to fix that. He was a brother. O-T-A-D-R. And he was an uncle. C-O-E. Okay. You're probably wondering what I'm doing. My line wasn't big enough, so I just continue typing, and I'm going to fill this in. Okay, I'm going to reduce this, how big the font is until I can get all those things in there, all the words in there on that one line. So I see this needs a little space here, so I'm going to space that out. My next label. I like the way the first two lines look. And then I'm going to highlight it. Also, I'm going to, since that one took a little bit more space, I'm going to add a little bit of space here. Let's pull this out. And then I'm going to say made ESPE, especially for you. I'm going to change the font so that it all gets on one line. Go down to my next line. Click on my words. I hope you are enjoying this video. Because it, even if you, you know, you don't understand what I'm doing or how I'm doing it, but if you do, that's great too. But I hope you just enjoy this video. I'll bring that up a little bit on that one. This one, I'm going to bring it up a little bit. I think that's where my date goes. And I'm going to say, got to highlight my letters. And then I'm going to put 10 slash, and today is October 3rd slash 21. Okay. And then I click outside of that and I kind of look and see, do I like everything the way it looks? This will even highlight the centering of it too, to make it sure it looks like it's, I saw I needed another word in here. I'm going to push a little, this over a little bit because I forgot my word by. Made for you by. Where is he? Okay, I got to. Oh, there we go. That's a little bit better. And I'm going to move that over just a hair. And the pink lines kind of made, center it for me. It's really an awesome program. And you can just have fun playing with it. So I like the way that looks. Okay, went back to look at my, whoops. Oh, I like that. Okay, got to bring it over just a little bit. Okay, now I click out of that. That'd be good. See this one, I'm gonna make this go down a little bit further. There, like that. Again, step out of it a second. There, I like that. So when I like what I've done, I wanna make sure that I save it. So I'm gonna save it. This save saves it to Canva. Okay, but I wanna download it to my computer. So I'm gonna move this over here. Okay, and I'm saving it in Canva to Quilt Label Templates. And I'm gonna do a PNG save. It gives it it highlights the photo. It gives it a good quality. I'm gonna download it to my computer. Okay, what I'm gonna do after it's downloaded, I'm going to go to my file on my computer and print it to my printer. And so I'm going to, I would go out of my, and I'm going to go to my computer and go to my download files. My downloads, and there's my custom quilt labels. I would select that. Oh, where did I get that? Okay. I would select that. I would select my file, Remembering Frank, and send it to my printer. But we're just going to print it on paper, on white paper, marking a little mark at the top of the page as it goes through the printer, because we want to remember which way it prints on the printer. So I will be back and we'll show you the next simple step of how to print this to your printer.
The label right here, Remembering Frank, and we're going to download it to my computer. Downloaded to my computer. Here we go. And I'm going to select PNG because that gives a high print quality image. Downloaded to my computer. There it goes. It'll just take a second. And then we're going to go back into my computer, into my downloads. And I'm going to select that file that I just downloaded. There's that. Okay, on my printer, that's an extra paper here. I'm just going to use one sheet. But I'm going to mark the top of the paper with just a mark because I want to see how that goes through the printer to make sure that it prints on that side for when I do the good. This is just a test. So I'm going to print. I think I do a command print. And it's, and for the sake of this example, I'm going to be very simple. I'm just going to print this label right in the center of the paper. As you get more technical about this, you could put it up in the upper hand corner. You could put several on one page, but just for this example, we're going to put it right in the middle and we're going to print. So there it's good. It should go to the printer. And it's going to start printing. So this is a way to get custom quilt labels for your quilt. So it's going to take a few minutes, but you can do all kinds of fonts, any kind of backgrounds. If you have personal pictures that you wanted to put in the back of there, you can do that. You can upload to Canva personal pictures. You can show transparency of those pictures in the background. You can make these labels very, very personal for your quilts, just like I did for my quilts. And there you can see it's printing. I like the way it's looking. Okay, and there's my little mark that's going to print on the good side of my paper. So I took a sheet of the fabric photo paper. It feels like it's like a almost like a plastic print on the back of it. And then this feels like fabric, just like fabric. So what I'm going to do is just put a little mark that's my right side going into the printer. And then I'm going to do on my MacBook Pro, Control P again and print. And that's going to print right on my good photo paper. Now, according to the instructions on the package of photo paper, you will follow the instructions on how to secure it once it's done printing. Just follow the instructions on it. So it should be printing. And make sure your ink is up to good quality as far as having a good ink ribbon in there. Color ink in there, your black ink is good so that you can get good color. And it just takes a few seconds to print, and there is our label. And according to the instructions, you would separate this from the backing, almost like an interfacing. Okay. Trying to get that separated from there. Pull it apart. And it acts just like paper too. It acts just like material too. And there is your custom quilt label. And then, like I said, according to the instructions, you would wash it. I wash it in the sink with a little bit of Dawn, and then I let it dry. And then I take care to iron it out and make it flat. Once you do print it on your printing, what I do is I cut about a half an inch around it, and then I will iron it so that goes around there. Then I will put this on. Usually I put it on the right hand corner of the back of the quilt, and there I have a custom quilt label for my quilt. If you would like, I hope this helps. If you know somebody that you would want them to make you a custom quilt label, definitely share this with them. If you want me to make you a custom quilt label, just send your name to my email address and say, hey, I want a custom quilt label made. My email address will be in the description. ritter.rozanne@gmail.com, and I will send you the information form to have a quilt label made, and then we'll get all your information. But I hope you enjoyed this. I really enjoy making these. I think they're a lot of fun, and they're so personable, and they will add value to your quilt, and you will enjoy it very much. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks. Have a good night.